The USA has always been a leading power in military aviation, striving not just to stay matched against other countries, but to set the very direction of aircraft manufacture. While other countries are still working to implement the fifth generation of fighter planes, the USA is already testing the sixth generation. In this video, you will learn about the design of these new generation fighters and the technologies involved, as well as what missions they will carry out. Before we get to these latest model fighters, however, let's look back at the course they have taken as they changed from one generation to the next. The first generation includes the earliest models of fighter planes. Among the pioneers were the German Me-262 and the British Meteor. They both entered service in 1944, and already by the end of World War II, the American F-80 fighters had appeared. What distinguished this generation was the revolutionary leap forwards in aircraft speeds, compared to their fellows with piston engines. The first birds of the second generation appeared on the battlefield during the Korean War. The most outstanding planes of this era were the F-86, the fearsome fighter of the US Air Force, and the Soviet MiG-15. For engineers, the main issue with this generation was adapting airframes to the new possibilities that jet engines brought. For example, creating more swept-back wings. Another lesson learned from the war was that infrared-guided missiles were better for shooting down enemy aircraft than aiming with a manual sight. The third generation included the US Air Force's so-called Century Series, the F-100, F-101, F-102, F-104, F-105, and F-106, as well as the Soviet MiG-17 and MiG-21. Their major advancements over their predecessors were their improved missiles, more advanced engines, and, of course, supersonic flight. The F-4 Phantom II, a two-seat fighter-slash-interceptor from McDonnell Douglas, is a legendary representative of this generation. The fourth generation arose in the 1970s, and representatives of this generation are still a mainstay of most countries around the world. Some models that must be mentioned are the F-15 and F-16 from the US, as well as the Su-27 and MiG-29 from Russia. The weaponry, avionics, and engines were significantly improved, and after 30 years of continuous improvement, some fighters were recognized as a more advanced generation 4.5. Among these were the aforementioned F-15 and F-16, as well as the Su-30, MiG-35, and Eurofighter Typhoon. The fifth generation was, until recently, the latest branch on the fighter family tree, though these fighters can now be seen as belonging to the past compared to the sixth generation now on the horizon. The first and foremost difference between these fifth generation fighters and their predecessors was the use of stealth technology. The second most important advance was equipping the aircraft with highly precise weaponry, innovative multi-spectrum sensors, radars, and an active electronically scanned antenna array, or AESA. The stars of this generation were the F-22 Raptor, introduced in 2005, and the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter, also known as the Lightning II. They were later joined by the Russian Su-57, Sukhoi PAKFA, and the Chinese Chengdu J-20 fighter. The Joint Strike Fighter Innovation Program took a big bite out of the American defense budget, some $1.7 trillion, and the price of a single Lightning II plane wound up being about $80 million. The engineers had gotten so carried away that in December of 2016, even President Donald Trump admitted that the cost of the F-35 program had gotten out of hand. Lockheed Martin made a great deal of effort to lower the cost of the program, but in the end, the media was still reporting figures of $1.5 trillion. as well as $36,000, the latter sum being how much operating a F-35 costs American taxpayers per hour. So, what about the sixth generation? What are the representatives of this new generation, and what are the key differences from previous designs? The project to build a sixth generation fighter started all the way back in 2008, when the US Navy launched the FAXX program. Some of you might have heard about it as the Next Generation Tactical Aircraft, or NGAD. At the same time, the US Air Force presented its own vision for the next generation, namely the Next Gen TACAIR, which in 2010 was renamed the FX program. In spring 2013, DARPA announced that they wanted to unite the US Air Force and Navy's designers in an attempt to create the perfect new generation fighter. Soon, however, DARPA abandoned this idea and instead recommended that the branches of service avoid a joint program to develop sixth-generation fighters. The reason was that previous joint US Navy and Air Force programs had to make compromises, which led to the planes ultimately being less powerful than they could have been, or more expensive than if they had been developed separately by those branches of the military. As a result of the lengthy development of their designs, the US Air Force and Navy ended up with some significant differences in the new generation jet engines. But the fighter's basic features proved to be similar. Among these were the use of AI to assist the pilot, improved systems for positioning, navigation and synchronization, as well as communication technologies that allowed transmitting large volumes of data between the planes of both branches of service. While the US Air Force saw stealth technology as the key feature of this new generation, the Navy sought to make the fighters of the FAXX program as agile as possible. And for that, they were ready to sacrifice even speed and payload. With the sixth generation fighter, the Air Force wanted to reduce the risk of the rollout of these planes being as long and drawn out as with the F-22 and F-35 models. And these branches of the military strove to keep their program's costs low and avoid repeating the mistakes of the JSF. The Air Force saw its task as not just building a fighter plane, but a whole set of systems, including communications, the latest high-tech weaponry, and space capabilities. Among the key innovations which the next generation of fighters will bring, and which set it apart from the fifth generation, one can point out the following. Stealth technology maximally improved. Equally effective use in any flight mode, from several times the speed of sound to subsonic flight. An improved exterior that boasts the aircraft's aerodynamics and has a self-healing function. The use of artificial intelligence to assist the pilot in difficult situations. Extremely sensitive sensors and state-of-the-art radars. Ability to change shape. Laser or directional energy weaponry, which, experts say, will be widely used in defense by 2030. The ability to control a swarm of drones from onboard the plane, or ideally, entrust the control of the drones to a pilot on the ground, or AI. If stealth began to be applied in the transition from the fourth generation to the fifth, then drone control, laser weapons, and advanced AI autopilot mark the technical breakthrough from the fifth generation to the sixth. Engineers took into account government authorities' worries about the huge cost of the program and the individual planes themselves. So this generation won't be making headlines about unreasonable spending. On the other hand, innovative technologies have never come cheap. And in the case of lasers, scientists have had to undertake an insane number of R&D efforts before they could equip fighter planes with such weapons. Things are simpler when it comes to drones, an industry that is very relevant today. As you can already guess, at the very core of this new fighter for both the US Air Force and Navy is autonomy. the ability to effectively wage war remotely using the latest technologies. The presence of the pilots in the cockpit, the companies involved tell us, will vary depending on the mission. Some engineering concepts have shown planes reminiscent of the Northrop Grumman X-47B, i.e. two-seat tailless jet planes with a blended wing. As for the planes being compatible with aircraft carriers and able to take off from them, the US military aims to successfully run fighters off Nimitz and Gerald R. Ford class carriers. Besides the attack capabilities of these future aircraft and the use of powerful weapons, many wonder if they will be able to stand up against the latest anti-aircraft batteries of Russia or China. Considering that American experts had previously called Russia's S-500, Prometi system an F-35 killer, in the new generation of fighters, this problem will be entirely eliminated thanks to the improved stealth technology. Moreover, due to its super-sensitive sensors and improved anti-aircraft detection system, the plane can easily avoid even the slightest chance of running into anti-aircraft fire. The first representative of the sixth generation is expected to enter service with the US Navy between 2025 and 2030. As for the US Air Force, they may employ their first brainchild between 2030 and 2050. What do you think of the latest fighters from the USA? Could they fundamentally change the rules of aerial warfare? Definitely tell us in the comments which features of the 6th generation fighters impressed you the most. Also, if you like this video, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and enable notifications so that you are always kept in the loop. See you soon!